I know. Whoever watches these is probably getting really sick of me. I'm getting really sick of me. So I don't blame you. I really don't. But if you're here anyway, welcome. Thanks for watching. If you're not, I understand. I really only do these for my own benefit, and who knows if I'm benefiting. I sure as heck don't. I just wanted to share, because it's like a video journal. This is exactly what I'm doing it for. I want to share what's going on with me. Because it's big. It's huge. It's like no different than usual, but it's stronger than ever. That voice that keeps calling me to leave him, to complain about him, to stand up to him, to fix him, to fix me, to stand up to myself, to find out what I want, to follow my heart, to love me enough to stop letting him control me. Is that better? Is that a better way of saying it? It's not about him, it's about me. Why am I having such a block? Why am I having such a hard time fathoming what to do about this? All right, I'm just going to speak in chunks, okay? Chunks. There was a chunk in the Monday night, because today's Wednesday, the 5th. Happy birthday, Grandpa. Wednesday, the 5th of February. Monday, I went to my therapy appointment, and I was contemplating before going, why am I going again? What does she do for me? My husband was angry with me. And one of our conversations was, he thanks my therapist for steering me in the direction of leaving him. And is that true? Is that what I want? No, what I want is to learn how to not let him affect me. And the leaving part isn't the end goal. Whether I leave or stay, I don't want to be affected by this man. Because even if I left, I would still be affected. Let me give you another chunk, okay? My friend Carrie was married to a man, narcissist, who was the meanest ever to her during their marriage. He even at one point was hanging out with a co-worker friend of his, a woman, and was blatantly open that they would have lunch together and they would hang out after work. And he just really was inappropriate. Without saying he cheated on her, he was probably cheating on his wife. And at some point, Carrie got wise and was like, you know what? Instead of being mad about all this, maybe I should friend her, you know? Keep your friends close, your enemies closer. And she became friends with this woman, and they would do stuff together with their babies and stuff. And she and her became really close, and she confided in this woman about her marriage. And whatever happened, I'm not really sure. One thing led to another, and all of a sudden this man is leaving his wife, right? And to this day, that coworker he was with all the time and her ex-husband are now married, and they have a baby together, I don't remember. Anyways, they're raising their kids together. So that's just a sad story. But I'm supposed to say this in chunks. He has manipulated their co-parenting so far into the fact that he took her to court and declared her an unfit mother, and now she has every other weekend with her son. And it's just messed up. She had, you know, CPS involved and all that, and she's not an unfit mother. And he's just that bad. He's that bad of a narcissist, manipulative, and she's never been able to stand up to him. Even when in their text messages, when she tries to, he comes right back at her. Or they have a mediating text messaging service now that has to monitor how they speak to each other or whatever. Basically, she was trying to show the courts what he does, and it's never really worked. So now she has to surrender and let her ex have sole custody of her son so he can have his little life with his new little wife and his little new family. And she's devastated, I'm sure, but she's had to move on from that. And to this day, he still controls the conversation. To this day, he's still, she doesn't stand up to him. She doesn't know how. She never learned how. She just surrenders and she lets him win all the time. Because he's a jerk and she has to live with that. And she's like counting down the days till their son is 18. And I guess he's like 11 or 12 right now. 10 or 11, I don't remember. Anyways, do you see my what I'm saying is, if I don't learn how to stand up to this man and not let him affect me like the way my friend's husband, ex-husband affects her still, even though they've been divorced for like 10 years, 8, 9 years, I don't know how long it's been, but it's been a long time since they've been divorced, and he still dictates the conversation. He still controls what happens in her life. She still has this, he still has this overpowering sense over her because she gives it away. I don't want to give my power away. So that's one chunk. Let's get that out of there. You understand what I'm saying? Whether I leave or I stay, I want to figure out my power and stop letting this man. I want to figure me out so I can stop letting him dictate the way I feel all the time. Okay? I know I'm. So, I'm running out of space, so it cut me off. And I really don't remember where I was at. And it's going to cut me off in a second again soon also. But I'm almost to work. So let's just talk about the chumps real quick, as quickly as we can. Another chunk is that my inner voice that's been begging me to figure this out has been putting me in a loop of anxiety, in a loop of emotions. I keep thinking and feeling and thinking and feeling and thinking and feeling and thinking and feeling, and it's driving me nuts. One of the stronger voices that I keep hearing is like Alice in Wonderland? No, it's Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz. Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz longed to know what was over the rainbow. Blue skies, birds flying, blah, blah, blah. She thought that her life sucked over there in Kansas, and once she got to the wonderful land of Oz, and she had all of her adventures and all of her scary things and all of the discomforts of being in an unknown place, and all of that contrast came up for her about friendship and love and acceptance and all that stuff, you know, and feeling like you're not good enough and all that stuff. All those emotions come up for Dorothy. If you're not familiar with how deep that movie goes, just watch it again and recognize that those are similar emotions that most of us feel as we're trying to mature and grow up. Anyway, we get to the end and she is told that even though she doesn't have the balloon to go back to Kansas, the Glinda, the good witch, tells her to click her heels. See my motion for clicking heels? Tells her to click her heels, and she had the power all along. So that's, of course, a voice in a story that's going on in my head that I have the power all along. I don't have to search my heart's desire to find where it is I belong or what it is I want. Without looking in my own backyard. It can be here. It can be here in this marriage. It can be here in this home. It can be here in this Kansas. I don't need to go over the rainbow and discover a land of Oz to find my happiness. And so that's a huge thing for me, to recognize that I am Dorothy in the land of, I'm Dorothy in Kansas, searching over the rainbow, thinking that's going to solve my problems, because I know it won't. I know leaving him will not solve my problems. And I don't think it will. So that's why I don't leave. That's why I don't just pack my bags and say, forget it. I understand the importance of commitment and marriage and family and two household incomes and but it doesn't feel good to feel unaccepted. it doesn't feel good to be told I'm not doing it right. That no matter what I do, it's going to upset him. And I understand that I can't control what upsets him and what doesn't upset him. And it bothers me to my core that me being myself upsets this man. That me being who I am upsets this man for whatever reason. For whether it be he doesn't think that I'm good enough, or that he thinks that I'm doing something I'm not, or whatever. It's his fears. It's his insecurity. I need to let go of him needing to be happy with me. If I can learn how to let go of him being happy with me, I don't care if it makes me leave or makes me stay. I'm not so afraid of leaving as I am. I'm afraid of staying and continually being unhappy. So I need to figure me out. I need to figure out who Crystal is, what Crystal wants, how Crystal can function without his happiness with me. And that's hard. I don't think anybody likes being around someone who is unhappy with them all the time. I just posted this morning on my channel that you're watching right now. I just posted this morning the video of him and I fighting. And it's filmed in a very sneaky way. He doesn't know I'm filming. And I feel really guilty about it. Like, I shouldn't do that. Like, I shouldn't post it. I shouldn't share it. I shouldn't have filmed it. I have guilt about it. And even as I'm posting it, I'm having this guilt and this feeling. And I'm like, then why are you doing it, Crystal? Why? So to ease my critical thinking, I changed it from public to unlisted. So if you can't find it and you can't see it, that's why. But there's a huge part of me that wants someone to help me, wants someone to guide me, direct me, and show me the way. Lead me, guide me, walk beside me, help me find the way. Teach me all that I must do. This is a stupid Mormon song that I would sing as a kid in the nursery. What do you call it? Oh, I'm such a mess. I'm tired of being a mess. I just want to have it figured out, and I don't want to be true to those stupid feelings that tells me I don't have it figured out. I don't want to be true to that anymore. I don't want to listen to it.